Hey, what's up everybody? The Destroyer here, and welcome back to the Elder Scrolls Morroblivion. This is part 30. And when we left off, I said I would loot a bunch of shit off camera and sell it, and I did just that. And I was at 12,590 gold, now I am at 18,233, and I actually still have some things to sell. Didn't sell the clothing, and I didn't sell this Fiend Battle Axe because it is worth a fortune. Also have this Cruel Spark Blade. I apparently forgot about that one, but otherwise, made a lot of money. So that is good news. Definitely a worthy endeavor to come down here and kill all these people. And have the guard get killed as well. The guard definitely needs me some cash. Alright, cool. So we'll carry on. We finished that quest, I guess. That Ritz. Now we have to go to the other place, which is far next to Belmora. Running backwards because I'm drinking. Can only play one-handed. There we go. We have full control again. Apparently there's a temple here as well. I wasn't aware of that. Could have went there the whole time. But I guess we joined the Tribunal Temple, so it's kind of cool at the same time. Alright, let me save here. Can't remember when the last time I saved was. Probably not that long ago. Should be safe. Alright, well, last time was a bit eventful. Let's see what we can do this time. Oh yeah, I'm not going to keep this helmet. I was just putting it on for fun. I'm keeping the helmet as a trophy. So I'm going to go put that in my house, I think. For now, I'm going to use my mask helmet. I do need to find some upgrade. Actually, you know what? I know what we can do this time. Completely random and off topic. But we'll have ourselves a little trip, I think, to get something. Let's go to Rethan Manor first, though. We'll store some stuff. We have a bit of crap that I don't want to carry around. I have a lot of moon sugar. I got a skooma pipe. That battle axe that's worth more money than anyone could actually offer me. I'll have to find one of the vendors with like the most gold to be able to get rid of that one. So I'll hold on to it for now. Welcome home. Oh, yes. Alright, so, let's see, how do I want to do this? Just drop the Indoril helmets. Jeez, that has like a big base, I wasn't aware of that. It's kind of strange. There's probably no easy way to do this. I don't want to knock over the candle either. I could put it up here, possibly. Let's drop it, there we go. Now I can reorganize it. Come on. I just want it to face forward. That's all I want in life. That's close. No! Can it not stand? I don't actually know. Huh. Perhaps I'm going to have to get a mannequin. I do have a mannequin mod installed. But I will have to go elsewhere to get that. I don't remember where they're sold. That's the thing. They're sold somewhere in Cyrodiil. Which actually is my next destination. I'm going to get something from Cyrodiil. So we're going to travel over to the Oblivion area and go shopping, I think. This is stolen shit. You know, I don't want to carry it around, so I'll store it all in here. I could probably pawn off some of the other stuff elsewhere. And this battle axe, put that in there as well. Put this down. 195, 270. I probably have a lot of other crap I don't want. Scuba pipe. I'll organize this stuff later. Normally I wouldn't throw everything into a one box, because that kind of annoys me to hell, but I'm not too concerned about it right now. I'll just throw everything in here, yeah. Oh wait, I had a... Give me that back. I just remembered I actually have a box for this kind of stuff already. Didn't I? One of these? Yeah. Might as well put them in there then. Let's put this on the bottom. There we go. Nice. Maybe I can pawn off some of this in Cyrodiil. I guess we'll find out. Alright, 187. That's not too bad in weight. Alright, let's make a small trip to Cyrodiil. I'm not going to spend too much time in Cyrodiil. At least not as of yet. as this is Elder Scrolls Morroblivion. I'll spend more time in Morroblivion. But I will be making trips here and there. It does cost me 2,000 gold to go there and back, so I mean, I don't want to do that too often anyway. But since I have a lot of cash on me, I think I can make the trip fairly easily. We'll just hope Sudden doesn't crash here. Good. Just turn off the shield for now. I'm gonna pick this lock. I hate this being locked. I mean, I can literally just jump over the fence on the side of it. But. So unimmersive. There we go. Ah, beautiful view of Vivec. It's quite nice, Horizon. Oh, shit. I need to go back home. I just remembered something. The ship captain's sister has a moon sugar addiction, and she pays 50 gold per moon sugar. So, if we go to Cyrodiil and bring her moon sugar, she'll pay us money. Might as well, because I can't really offload this stuff otherwise. 50 gold isn't too bad either. Oh, wrong one. Sorry about the backtracking. What was it called? M. Cool. That'll be some extra coin, which I'm always alright with. Alright, now we travel to Sidonine. And then, once we get to Cyrodiil, we'll have to go to... What town was it? I think it was the shitty one. I forget what it's called. Is it Breville? Or is it Coral? I don't remember. I know where it is on the map, though. Fine mouth. He has such a fine mouth. Hello, friend. Ever want to get off this rock? I can take you to the Imperial City in Cyrodiil for a small consideration. Destination. 1,000 drakes up front. You'll be there in about 3 days if weather cooperates. Yes, let's go. Very well. If you follow me, we can start making preparations. And off we go. Alright, cool. I do have some, a lot of mods, actually, for base Oblivion. Like, textures, replacers, and stuff. So, it looks better. Kasimba, have you ever seen the beauty of Vvardenfell? I can get you there for a small fee. She's the one who takes me back. No. The brother was supposed to tell me about his sister, and he didn't. Alright, well, I had a crash when I went to Oblivion. Or Cyrodiil. But I came back and I talked to him about his sister before I went back. So I'm going to go through this with you guys first. So, sister, yes, my littermate lives in Imperial City and works in Imperial Legion headquarters. We run a little travel brokerage together since there are always people coming and going between here and there. And of course, she has a few problems that I help her with. She is my littermate after all. Problems. Problems, yes. That one has a bit of a sweet tooth, if you follow me. Alright, quest updated, short trip. So let's save our game now. I have no idea why it crashed when I went to a...
Good day.
There. Let's try it this time. Should be alright. I've never had base Oblivion crash on me before, so that was a little weird. It seemed random as well. Alright, have you ever seen the beauty of Vvardenfell? I can get you there for a small fee. We are going to talk to him about... Yes, I'm a littermate of... Him. I just work here, that's all. They pay me a pittance to keep the grounds clean, but they also overlook my travel business with my brother Tesh. I guess it evens out in the long run, but I sure don't enjoy sleeping in that drafty basement. The food in the mess hall is good enough, although not sweet enough for my taste. Problems. Problems? Perhaps you can help this one with problems. Help. Yes, tell you what. If you find any moon sugar when you're in Vvardenfell, bring it to this one. No sugar here in the Imperial City. Sugar. Do you have any sweet sport treats for this one? Yes, here you go. Thank you so much, sweet sugar light of the moon. I think moon sugar removed, 50 gold added. I will actually have to do this, Oh, I was talking. Have you ever been to Elsewhere? Have I been to Elsewhere? No, I haven't been there. I was born there, but I don't remember. They say sugarcane groves of the Tenmar Forest are beautiful at night. It is where the sugar comes from. One day I'll go back. They have the sweetest sugar there, they say. The bakers make candies, cakes, sweetmeats, and all little slice of the moon. Not like the bland roughage they have here. Real sweets, so sweet they would make your tongue curl. My brother Tesh buys them for me when he goes to Elsewhere, but Although he hasn't been there many moons, I also ask him to take me, but says he would lose me. Oops. If you ever go to elsewhere, promise you'll take me with you. Probably won't. Talk to her about Jotesh. My brother? Ha! Jotesh calls himself. Joe means wizard. If you didn't know that. The wizard, can you imagine? No, I suppose you wouldn't know. He is no wizard. I've never seen him with so much as a flick of flame from his finger. He thinks it's funny. You'll have to ask him if you want to know why he calls himself Jotesh. Used to be just Tesh. I'm still just Kasimba. Okay. Interesting. Alright, well, I'll come back and I'll sell that moon sugar before I leave Cyrodiil. For now, let's get into the city. I should probably save my game as well, just in case. Let's hit a new save there. Nice. Alright, there's the Imperial City. Very nice sight. And we have, of course, Cyrodiil. The very green, very different land to Morrowind, huh? Ah, it's great. It's good to be back. I guess for this character, it wouldn't be back. This would be the first time we've ever came to this place. It's a strange land to us. Although technically maybe not, because we are an outlander. Brought in from a prison ship to Morrowind. So perhaps we were from here originally. Hard to say. Alright, there's a lot of people. Oh, that's right, there's capes. I forgot! Oh, shit. How goes it? Well, I have a cloak mod, as you see here. They don't show up in Morrowind, but the people of Cyrodiil do have them. And I love them. I want one for myself. I can buy them, as a fact, somewhere. One of these stores sells cloaks.
So, have you bet on any arena matches?
There it is. Let's go to the copious coin purse. And of course, people of Oblivion have voice acting, so I don't actually have to read out things. Which is, I guess, good.
What kind of deal can I make for you today?
Well, that's a good question. What can you do?
I offer the finest goods and lowest prices in all Cyrodiil.
Oh, he's got a beggar's cape and a beggar's cape tee. The difference is one works with regular stuff, one works with modded stuff, I believe. You probably don't want a beggar's cape, huh? Clovian wool, dark leather. Let's make him like us first.
This better be good.
We are on a shopping spree.
Every little bit helps.
So we'll,
let's do business.
We'll buy some stuff while we're here, you know. Although I do need to probably go buy the more important things first. I am here for a set of items. But they do cost money. They're not free by any means. A fine peasant's cape. Alright, let's get the dark leather cape.
No deal.
Ah, shit. So yeah, there's not going to be much action in this episode. There's going to be a lot of...
Make me a better offer.
A lot of trading, a lot of travel. So if you don't like that, apologies.
Make me a better offer.
Shit! This guy's a freaking terrible bargainer.
No deal.
Really? All right, 60%? Surely. I mean, come on. Fuck. I guess we can get all these capes. Might as well.
You drop.
Scorpion cape, okay. Virtuous blood cape. A lot of the stores have capes too. It's not just this guy. Alright, let's take a look at him.
Goodbye.
Oh yeah, I have a color replacer for my map for Oblivion. Looks cool. It's very vibrant. Alright. Let's see. It won't work with the glass armor, I have no doubt. Maybe. Probably not. That one does. See these beggar's cape. Oh, that one does too. I guess the glass armor is from Base Oblivion, isn't it? So that's a beggar's cape. Still cooler than nothing, but still, that one's kind of dirty looking. That, on the other hand, is pretty neat. Dark leather cape. Oh, I gotta take this one off, that's right. That's the dark leather cape. Kind of fits with our hood almost. Fine peasant's cape. It's not too bad. Scorpion cape. Ooh. Fancy. Virtuous blood. Interesting. Well, for now, we'll wear the dark leather cape, I think.
Please, come again.
Cool. There are more capes, though. I'm going to go find real fast. Render staffs. Actually, you know what? I'll get some capes on the way back. I think for now we need to go get what I came for, and then I'll see how much money I have left. It's Breville. That's where I need to go. To the archery store. Alright, cool. So we'll come back from Oblivion. I keep calling it Oblivion. The game is Oblivion. We'll come back from Cyrodiil. God, the game looks so good, doesn't it? Look at this.
Hi.
That looks like Skyrim level almost of graphics.
We have no ammo. And
crazy.
No
Alright, well, it's a bit late, it seems. Might have to stay in a tavern. Can we just wait? I guess we could. We'll go stay in a tavern anyway. It's immersive. It's a merce. Is that a tavern, or is it the Mage's Guild? I think it's the Mage's Guild. Let's actually equip this. There we go. Mage's Guild. Okay. Not going to join the Guild of Mages right now. That light. Lights from here to that bridge. That is a far light. 60 feet is no slouch. Alright, this is a tavern, huh? Lonely Suitor Lodge? Yes. We require a bed.
How are you?
Hello, Gita.
What can I do for you?
Oh, nothing, apparently.
Be seeing you.
His armor looks cool. It's like black steel. Oh, that's the Blackwood Company stuff, huh? I remember.
Hello, stranger. Luciana Galena. I'm Breville's advanced trainer for the light armor discipline.
Are you now?
Good that you want to get better.
Oh, we can actually train. Okay.
Pay attention and you can learn a lot.
Let's make her like us. Actually, no, let's not do that yet.
I don't know what you're talking about. I don't buy or sell things.
I'm not convinced.
Take care.
So you're not the proprietor of this place?
I'm Brogram Grogalash, your host at the Lonely Suitor Lodge. It may not look like much outside, but that's just the weathered Breville look.
All right, we will require a bed, sir.
Yeah, I've got a room. 10 gold for the night. You sure you want it?
Yes.
It's upstairs on the top floor. Only room I've got. I think both beds should be clean enough, so use whichever you prefer.
All right, I'll do that. Thank you.
Goodbye.
It's not that one.
Hello.
Top floor, he said, right?
The Emperor and his three sons dead. Right under the noses of the Imperial Guard. It's a disgrace.
Oh, yes. The talking that Oblivion has. Ah, excellent. So nostalgic. I love it. Although I have been playing, Oblivion for a little bit, so it's not too nostalgic, but still, I hadn't been here yet. 10 a.m., that should do. I think all the shops would be open by then. I've heard a rumor that a strange doorway is open on a small island in Nibbin Bay. I should investigate. Oh god, are we going to get all the Oblivion quests now? No? Alright, it's definitely daytime.
Do you want something from me?
What's happening?
Not really. Oh, even the Blackwood guy has a cape. That's cool. I just want a black cloak. That'd be cool.
Me children are starving.
It looks kind of funny though when like people, like a beggar has a cloak. But I guess, I mean, they can have a cloak. Alright, the Archer's Paradox. That's where we need to go. Hello, Daylin?
The Archer's Paradox. Because a perfect arrow flies forever, and that's impossible. I'm Daylin, and I have no perfect arrow.
It's not a very good selling point, I'm going to be honest. Alright, well.
Go ahead.
Let's bribe him up.
See? Was that how I offer the finest goods and lowest...
Alright, we're still at 15,000, that's good. Let's go up to 70 for him, maybe he'll work with us? Probably not. He's got a bow of affliction, 16... Jesus Christ, that bow is beastly! Also super expensive. I'm here for the Ranger's Shroud stuff. That is the armor set right there. It's not cheap, that's why I saved a bit of money.
You've got to be kidding.
That is a modded armor set. I added in.
Pleasure doing that. You're a fine.
But it's not an OP armor set. That's why I like it. And it looks super cool.
I appreciate your.
It'll definitely accentuate the fact we look like an assassin. Which is really what I was going for. Alright, what is it called? Ranger's Shroud. Let's compare it to our stuff, actually. It's actually worse. The Curious is one less defense. But, if I'm going for looks, which I am, it looks fucking cool. Look at that. There's a hood. And there's even a mask. Oh, I look like an assassin. I love it. All we need now is a cape that'll work with this. So I'd have to use, like, the dark leather cape won't work, but the dark leather cape T will. So we'll have to find a black cape. Like a legit black cape. And then that should fit. But yeah, very cool. Oh wait, does it take the cape? Ah, we can't have a cape and a mask at the same time. Okay, I guess we won't have a cape. Because I do want the mask. Cool, cool, cool. I've been playing for 15 minutes. Excellent. It's all I've ever wanted. I do have a Dark Brotherhood set of armor as well. It's called like Elite Dark Brotherhood armor or something. But you have to do Dark Brotherhood stuff in this game to actually get that, so. How much money do I have left? Do I have enough for that bow? I do. Should I get that bow? It's super expensive, but
pleasure to
speak.
I offer the finest goods and lowest prices in all Cyrodiil.
I mean, it's 16 damage. My bow right now only does 11. You know what? Let's get it. It's good against marksmen, of all things. Its enchantments aren't great. Drain marksmen 15 points and drain agility. It makes other archers crap. Now that I look at it, I don't know if I want it. Ah, fuck it. It's still a better bow than what I'm using. I still have 3,000. Alright, you can have a bone mold bowl then. Bow. I always call it a bowl. I don't know how that word enters my mouth.
An excellent bargain. Thank you.
All right. Well, we've had a
take care
productive trading day here in Breville. I'm sure there's other things we could get in Oblivion here in this place, but for now, we won't worry too much about it. We'll come back at a later time. What kind of bow is this? Is that ebony? I think that's what ebony looks like in Oblivion. Sweet. So we got ourselves an ebony bow. Let's put that on too. There we go. Very nice. And that's what we look like with the put on a cape. I mean, if I find a black cloak, I could actually not use the mask. Sometimes. But the mask just makes him look evil and cool. So I'm gonna keep it. Alright. Well, the shield really doesn't fit. That's why I like keeping it off. I'll just use it for battle when I need to. But for now, we look like a true assassin should. But we are still not overpowered or anything. We're actually less powered than we were. So I think that balances it out. I didn't want to put in an armor set that was like super elite that I could just get and be like, oh, hey, look at me. Save. That's what I wanted to do. Alright, well, should we take a look around the stores here real quick? Let's take a look at the fair deal. What do they got?
You always get a fair deal here. I'm Nilowin. What can I get you?
What can you get?
May I interest you in some of my fine wares?
A burgundy cape? We'll buy it, the T one. A hunter's cape.
I let that go too.
Will you do 50%? A patch cape? Quilted mantle?
An excellent deal.
Russell and felt cape. Since we're not going to be coming back too much, I want to kind of get all the capes I can.
A pleasure.
The T1 seemed to work with anything, so.
Bye.
Might as well just get those. I don't know where you would find a black cape.
I'm listening.
Fighters Guild. A house. What is this? A Warlock's Luck. We'll see what they got.
Take a chance on the Warlock's Luck. Just kidding. Everything is all perfectly safe. Tested it myself. Ungarian, retired adventurer. You may have heard of me.
No, I haven't. Sorry,
have
buddy.
Have a look at my wares. I'm sure there's something to suit you.
You're wrong, my friend. You're very wrong.
Farewell.
Nothing I require from you, sir. Good day, sir.
Hello.
Alright, well, I'm running out of time here, so I'll just continue looking around. Let's head to a different town. Maybe Coral? Let's try Coral. I mean, the Imperial City's probably got the best options for stuff. They have the most stores. It's possible I could have found one there. But on my off-camera game, a long time ago, I found a no black cape. I don't think.
Greetings, Dunner.
So I'm gonna look around for a black cape. I might even end the video here. We'll explore coral a little bit. I'll let you guys see some coral. Looks fantastic.
Nothing I'd like to talk about.
Greetings.
I see.
What is the coral cape look like?
The Fighters Guild is recruiting again.
Stop looking at me, you bastard.
Not a bad way to make some money if you've got the stones for it.
Oh.
You won't let me look at this cape. What a prick. I've always loved Coral. Coral's one of the cooler cities. It looks kind of like a fancy city. Who knows? Maybe someday we'll get a house here. Once we start playing more of the base game.
Hello. I'm Rashida, the smith. And this is Fire and Steel. Quality armor and weapons. Repairs, too. What can I do for you?
Well, you can let me look
what
at your wares,
I suppose. What can I interest you in?
I don't know why I came to the actual fortify armor and strength. Huh. I was kind of curious what daggers they would have.
Good day.
Nothing even close to what I have. My glass dagger is actually pretty good. But yeah, I think it's about time to end the video. I'll continue shopping around, looking for a black cloak off camera. And then, we'll probably head back to Morrowind. Because I'm not quite ready to be here yet. I just wanted to make a quick stop. We'll come back and do some Dark Brotherhood missions here and such. And since I have a Dark Brotherhood expansion mod, that should be fun to play with as well. Because it goes past the end of the Dark Brotherhood and into,
let's hear it,
unexplored territory that I've never seen. But yeah, for now, that has been part 30 of The Elder Scrolls Morroblivion. So join me again next time, and we will carry on. So see you next time.